Madam Speaker, I rise in strong support of H.R. 3401. We have all seen the tragic pictures of immigrants held in extremely overcrowded CBP facilities, never designed to hold families and tender-age children. I and many colleagues have been to the border and witnessed firsthand the horrific, indisputably untenable and intolerable conditions. This bill addresses this humanitarian crisis and sets forth strong oversight provisions and requirements to ensure the basic humane care of migrants in custody, especially the children. Funding for the Department of Homeland Security totals nearly $1.5 billion, $150 million above the Senate committee bill. This crucial funding will directly address the humanitarian crises at the border by supporting temporary CBP holding facilities to relieve the dangerous overcrowding and by providing medical and transportation support, blankets, food, water, and other consumables for migrants. Combined with funding in Title III for unaccompanied children, the bill also provides resources needed to reduce time in CBP custody and to ensure their facilities are safe, sanitary, and humane. The bill also includes $200 million for an innovative multi-agency pilot program to better address the medical and legal needs of families and unaccompanied children. It will also improve the department's efficiency in migrant processing without compromising migrant legal protections. This pilot will collate Customs and Border Protection, Immigration and Customs Enforcement, Citizenship and Immigration Services, the Office of Refugees Resettlement, and nonprofit humanitarian organizations into a single facility. This will reduce overall processing time, provide consistent medical assessments and treatment, and offer legal orientation much earlier. Nonprofit organizations will provide assessments of migrants' needs and vulnerabilities and help families transition to local shelters or alternatives to detention. The bill also includes $60 million to help nonprofits and local jurisdictions continue their efforts to provide assistance to migrants released from DHS custody. The Office of Refugee Resettlement is nearly out of money. Without additional resources for sheltering capacity, children will continue to be held for weeks or longer in ill-equipped CBP holding facilities never intended to hold children for more than a few hours. Let me be clear. Without passage of this bill, the only alternative is the Senate bill, which has insufficient oversight provisions and leaves the door open for further abusive behavior by the administration. H.R. 3401 takes a constructive, balanced approach with the right mix of funding and oversight. Madam Speaker, Congress simply cannot adjourn without providing the funding needed to address the humanitarian crises and trauma of migrants and their children at the border. The only way to ensure the inclusion of strong oversight, compliance requirements, and priorities in the emergency supplemental package is to pass H.R. 3041. I urge my colleagues to vote yes on the supplemental, and I yield back the balance of my time.